You're looking at a picture of a Western Electric Model 554 wall telephone. Western Electric was a division of AT&T and was subsequently their primary source of telephone equipment for a very long time, from probably the 1930s or 40s up until the 80s, when the Bell system was forced to break up and they made it possible for you to own your own phone. Prior to that, you would rent a phone from AT&T and you basically got what they gave you. You had some other choices, like you could get a trimline phone or whatever, but this was the base model wall phone. But in many parts of the country, your phone service wasn't provided by a Bell system phone company. And since these independent phone companies really didn't relish the idea of purchasing their phones from AT&T, who they saw as their primary competition, there was another company who sold phones and was the largest supplier of phones to independent telephone companies. This is my automatic electric Model 90 wall telephone. These were manufactured by Automatic Electric from 1959-ish until sometime in the mid-70s. Automatic Electric was from 1955 on, they were founded in 1901, but from 1955 on they were a division of GTE and was their primary telephone equipment supplier. Automatic Electric got its start making telephone switching equipment, which allowed people to call people directly without having to go through an operator. As we do now, you pick up your phone and dial a number, which was brand new, and that came around in the late 1800s. And for many, many years, it was strictly the independent telephone companies that purchased the switching equipment to allow for direct dialing. AT&T's Bell system stuck with live operators for many years until a strike one time brought the company pretty much to its knees as far as being able to provide service, an operator strike. And then they reluctantly purchased switching equipment to begin the process of modernizing their system from Automatic Electric. This phone I have had since sometime probably in the late 90s. I bought it off of eBay. There used to be an eBay seller on there who sold all kinds of these phones from Automatic Electric that were all fully refurbished. The plastics on them were cleaned and buffed and pretty much made to look and operate as new. They were converted to a modular plug so that they would you'd be able to plug them into a standard phone jack. Prior to that, if back in the day, these would have been hardwired. You would have had a wire sticking out of your wall where it was to mount with spade connectors on the end, and they would manually connect it up, hardwire it right to the wall. But this, so it has the modular plug. That's the only update really to it, other than it has an extra long, like 25 foot handset cord on it, so I can pretty much walk anywhere on the main floor of my house almost with this, you know, in my hand and still not run out of cord. Let's take a little up close look at it now. Right in the middle there, if you can see, is the AE logo. It's kind of hard to tell. It's the upper two, oops, where are my finger here? Okay. The upper two parts of that triangle says AE, and then there's just two triangles in the bottom part. that was their logo. And it is a, you know, a regular rotary dial phone. This is what the dial sounds like when you dial it. Notice there's no sound at all when you move the dial over to the finger stop. Only when you release it. And it does work. It is plugged in. You can hear the dial tone. Let's look the, this is what the inside of the handset looks like. There's no Made in USA on the handset or any information on the inside of the handset. But the company was based out of Chicago, and this is a US made phone, probably dating from the 60s. It's in the seafoam green color, which was a fairly popular off, you know, color other than the standard white, black, or beige. It does have a metal switch hook on the side. This phone was basically the answer to Western Electric's 554. Automatic Electric didn't want to be a copycat company making basically the same phone as AT&T. They wanted their phones to stand out and be unique. And they made some really cool looking phones back in the day, this being one of them. So now let me get my phone here and I will make it ring. There you have it. My Automatic Electric Model 90 wall phone. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Take care now. Bye.